Hello, rookie training tubers, and welcome back to Let's Play XCOM The Long War with me, BlueAnkylo. In the last episode, we shot down a small UFO, and I'm hoping it's nice and easy so that we can let some specialists and rookies get some promotions relatively safely. So in the past, we've found that most shot down smalls are relatively low numbers of aliens, like 10 or so, or less anyway. And we've had a couple what might have been ambushes where they landed and managed to set up a really, really strong force. Now, the rookies did pretty good that time. Hopefully the aliens haven't, like, teched up more since then or just generally give us a hard day. But I'm hoping this is a nice, easy mission. So you'll see some friendly faces from before that have seen you in a previous life anyway. We've got Snowman with the guns. We've got Fella McGubbins with the shotguns. We got Killifron with a sniper this time. We've got Daniel Garcia, who... Scout, right? Scouty-D-Scout. And then four more new ones I've renamed in here. We've got Surfius Tidalor with low accuracy and a carbine. So we'll see how he does. Nice and mobile, anyway. And we've got Oda Sakai again. Very good accuracy and mobility. We've got Josh Foster again, who has pretty decent stats all around. And finally, Major Lee Bear is back. And I don't know, I think I've managed to pick out relatively decent stats for what I'm for what I prefer anyway. And we're gonna bring a couple flashbangs on the rookies, a couple grenades on the rookies, so that they have a little bit more tactical options depending on what we run into. No, we're not worrying about capturing this time. I think it's smarter to just, you know, make sure we can survive. I'm going to put a cut in the video, and if this mission turns out super boring and easy, I'll just meet you guys once it's over. Alright guys, so I decided to cut that mission because it really dragged on, and it was actually pretty easy, although there may have been a couple people who died. It was just, I mean, you'll see who was the aliens. It was just a group of thin men and a group of floaters with the outsider. And we lost a couple operatives because of mostly bad luck. The thin men have so much mobility, they were able to just run super long distance and get a flank shot on one of our rookies, who then panicked and then ran right into open, and then the other thin man killed him. And then the other one was killed by a floater overwatch that I couldn't see, so I was trying to find where the aliens were, and he got shot on a reaction fire. So we lost two rookies, which may be unfortunate for them, but it doesn't really cost us anything too much. So yeah, I think Josh, I mean, both of them got a kill, which is kind of unfortunate for the order. But, yeah, I think Josh was the one that got flanked and panicked, and then Surfius just got an unlucky overwatch. Daniel has now gone on... Oh, sorry, I was like, how did you go on three missions without getting a promotion? Our scout is not doing terribly good at killing. It's just scouting. Anyway, we've got another chance for assault or an infantry here. Nice aim. Good mobility. Either option would be fine. I think, wasn't Oda... Were you an infantry last time? I can't remember. I think I'll give you infantry again. I like infantry. I like assault too, don't get me wrong, but... An extra infantry is fine. And Major Bear... You do not have enough mobility to be a great scout, in my opinion. Your accuracy is above average. You could make another sniper. I think we just give you a random. We see what we get. I don't really care what I get anymore, so... Infantry! I mean, okay, we got a double infantry day. I can't complain. It doesn't really matter. I think I've got enough people that it's okay. So yeah, you can see we killed four floaters, four thin men, plus the outsider. And, yeah, it was a pretty easy mission. I made a couple... Maybe I made a bit of a mistake here and there. I don't think you guys will sweat too much by not seeing that. We get a little bit of money for our trouble. And I suppose I can show the memorial. So we had two rookies completely destroyed on Operation First Mother. Yeah, the thin man was the flank panic flank. The floater was just a lucky shot. So there you go. So don't worry, you two. I'll resurrect you eventually. Oh, also, I decided one thing that I sort of incorrectly reported is the way... the scans work. I was saying, like, I can't afford the $50. Well, assuming we survive the mission, you should actually get, like, 100 or 150 back. So you do get a net positive as long as you don't lose the mission. So I say we do a scan. Intel scan. We found one positive ID on in the UK where we know they don't have a base, and it's already an alien occupation, but okay. So, oh wait, do I have to...
And you're positive the report states...
So, we're gonna pick, I think is it Monkey Mark is doing all of our covert ops? So yeah, we'll let Monkey Mark continue, I think. We'll give you the heater, we'll give you some survivability, I believe. It's pretty hard to survive grenades if they throw grenades at you. And finally, I'll give you... Sheesh, I don't know. What would keep you alive the best? Maybe a flashbang or something so you could... I think flashbangs mess up their... I don't know if it affects the exalts, rockets, and grenades, but whatever. That's the kind of thing that might keep you alive, the way I see it. So there you go. Good luck, Monkey Mark. I pressed the wrong button, apparently. Okay, go. There you go. Okay, well, let's see if we can finally get our armor anyway. That's what I really want. Or we could just have unending smalls. Ah, we're going to run out of free aircraft. I think last episode I was saying how it seems like I've got a pretty good supply on the air game lately. But, well, we'll see how we do here. If you can catch it. Can't. Seriously? Gonna fly across the whole world?
Bangs out.
What was that about? Alright, please shoot it down. One shot, two shot, three shot, good. We took a little bit of damage. We got $100 for it. Keep people a little bit happier. I think what I need to do is move one of our remaining ships over. So if we get another one in 2 days, at least we'll have the chance to shoot it down, or at least, you know, go have a look. Alright, can we... Where's my... The heck is going on? Oh, the interceptor was flying back and it wouldn't let me scan for some reason. Anyway, let's get our armor. Yeah, that's a lot of money! 20 Illyrium would normally be 7 each. So you get 140. That's double. I know I was saying I didn't want to give up my Illyrium, but that is just too good to I can't turn down that much Illyrium. Alright, so we've got Carapace and Kestrel armor. At long last, we get some useful armor. And, sheesh, what's next? I know people want to see mechs. You know, we are going to have to research Illyrium eventually. Goss. I think we do the quick stuff. So we do a couple autopsies and the UFO analysis. Should only take a couple days. We'll get that out of the way quick. Let's have a look at our armor. So, was there any... It's in this one, yeah. So Carapace is our new TAC armor, basically. 5 HP instead of 2. And I think it has the same weight, although maybe I'm incorrect. And then Kestrel is our new light. It's not great, but it's very light, so you got high mobility and still better armor than a vest. So I think what we do, we should have enough. I want to build at least 2 Kestrels, one for a scout, one for, how many do I want? At least 2 sniper and scout for sure, and then that'll do for now. And then I want to build mostly Kestrel or mostly Carapace to keep sort of our heavies alive. It's a lot of money, it's a lot of alloys, that's all our alloys. But then we can squad 8 people with at least better armor. I think it's, overall, it's going to be a good idea. So, goodbye alloys and a lot of our money. I think we spend a bit more of our money, seeing as we're not going to be able to make much without any alloys, on a couple more scopes, maybe? Scopes are pretty solid. Could make one more arc thrower, sure, we'll make one more arc thrower. And 2 more scopes. I don't want to just burn through all of our cash, but if there's no alloys, we're not going to be building much, you know, other stuff for a bit anyway, until we get some. And I think that does it. We've got an alloy shiv on the way. 9 days. That should be fun. Is there any other accessories I would want to give him? I started the laser pumper, didn't I? Yeah, I started the laser pumper. So we'll have at least one of most of this stuff. I don't think I need that. It's not a bad one, but it's not what I want. You know, we don't have any spare satellites. If one gets shot down, our current satellite we'll lose it. So are at full capacity. We might not finish that in time. But I like to have at least one or two spares in case satellites get shot down. Alright, that's it. Let's go.
Contact detected.
Dang it! This is like... This must mean we've had four fighters in a row. I mean, there's... Our interceptors did good. They shot everything down. But that's the fourth UFO in like a week. So there's just nothing I can do. We're going to lose another satellite.
Commander, we've lost some of our satellites.
What am I supposed to do, guys?
Any UFO contacts in that area.
I can't afford an infinite supply of interceptors. Ugh. So what does that put us at in the... They shot down the satellite over the UK, I think. The UK is borderline... Oh, no, it's the United States. The UK is already gone. No, they shot... Sorry, that was my bad. They shot down the one in Russia, which doesn't matter as much because Russia is relatively happy. It's North America that's doomed. Europe is doing surprisingly well, and so is Asia. I mean, I keep talking about spreading my satellites to Asia eventually, but... Obviously, we can't even defend two continents yet. Alright, what do we get here? It'll be easier to shoot down harvesters, the large ones that we have no chance at shooting down anyway. I think they've got too much armor, basically. We need better weapons. Alright, well, let's do some quick autopsies. Let's have a look at the chrysalids. I'm sure you guys love to see what chrysalids can do. Looks like we get a covert op. Okay, do we get four or do we get eight? We get four. So this is the quick in-and-out mission. I am going to set up the squad off camera so I can pick the people I want to pick, and I will see you guys in a second. Alright, I decided to go with some corporals for this mission. So we've got Alpha the Mage with the infantry corporal. We've got Draco Delacroix for the sniper. We've got Lord Prey for scout. And Gunfodder for our spare medic. We're not planning on doing much fighting, though. We're hopefully able to just... Hack those comm relays and get out before we get bogged down with too many exalt these things. These exalt missions definitely get more and more ridiculously unfair as the campaign progresses, in my opinion. So I'm hoping that we maybe get a lucky layout or something so that we can activate the comm relays relatively quick. That looks really good. That looks like we can get one on the first turn, actually. Although maybe we should go that way first. I don't know. Yep, thanks, Central. Just, you know, we've done this like half a dozen times already. Alright, so... Monkey Mark could definitely hit that relay. Thing is, it might be safer to go that way first. The thing is, I'm expecting to trigger Exalt like all through the fog of war. And while this is a better, more defensible position for Monkey Mark, I think being able to hack on the first turn is just too valuable. I think we move, hack, and then try to find some more full cover so that next turn we can hack and then start moving towards the extraction, which is a fair ways away. So that's the strategy. Let's see how it goes. Yeah, so we found one. That's actually not bad.
Enemies in sight.
Or three. Never mind.
Is in position near a comm relay. We just need to activate.
Might be able to kill those with our extraction team.
You've decrypted a piece of
so
data,
and it looks I don't like really want to spawn any more. I think we put you here.
Now we just need to find the remaining relays.
Please don't see any more. Of course. See, we would have run into those guys and the other group we spawned basically no matter what we did. So, here we go. Can we provide any support at all? I think Draco, or sorry, Lord Prey, you being the commanding lieutenant, you've got a nice flank here. And you didn't do much damage, but you tickled him. Sniper does not have a shot. Alpha, you know, I happen to know there's one over there. Cover doesn't matter much. Just in range, too. If you could just kill this guy. There you go. Because they can't shoot at us, the best they can do is throw grenades. And the more of them we can just kill right off, kind of the better. 54%. Eh, take the shotgun fodder. Nice! And the sniper... We don't want to move any more to the right, so I think I just put the sniper behind this truck. And if you had snapshot, you'd be able to take a possible kill there. Alright, just hope that they don't throw a bunch of grenades on our operative, and then if that doesn't happen, we'll be fine. Now those three are like the meld super soldiers, I believe, so they are particularly annoying. Wouldn't it be cool if they completely surrounded the comm relay so we couldn't hack it? That'd be some next-gen strats. Alright, so they're dropping in from, I guess, a helicopter right in our face. So it looks like we're going to have to deal with these two this turn. I think, Monkey Mark, you got to continue hacking. And...
That's it, Commander.
You can start running back now. Yes, I know, Central. Seriously, I know what to do. Okay, let me go. Okay, good. I wish it didn't take control of your camera. Because, like, you know, I know what I want to do. Alright, so I don't think Monkey Mark will be able to escape next turn, but maybe the turn after. So, Alpha, what do I want to do with you? I would like you to kill the sniper there, actually. Let's move you here. See if you got an angle. You do. Okay, take that guy out. Because he is most likely to be annoying for our scout.
No longer.
And then we got two. We got a sniper. Just got 100%. Kind of wish I had an assault in this situation. I think Lord Prey takes the easy flank. And then maybe we kill it with the medic. We move gun fodder over to here.
I'm on it, Commander.
So that's safer. Although they, I mean, we're putting ourselves in a nasty grenade setup. But, see, what is that? That's heavy infantry. Elite heavy. Iron skin even, hey? That's kind of cool. I'd like that. Yeah, I love that. It's got holo targeting rockets. It's got a lot of stuff. But I think we take this shot on the operative, because it's the one that's more likely to have a grenade. Well, we could kill him. We're not going to be able to kill this guy. So we still take the lower shot just because it's a kill chance. Maybe? Yeah! I mean, 12 damage actually would have been enough to kill even that guy. Still, that was a pretty good turn. We killed three of them, I believe. We're definitely not going to stick around to fight them all, but that was a nice reload. Now, that's a heavy, remember. We want to kill that guy ASAP, or else he will rocket us to smithereens. Now, the guys dropping down will have their ammo ready to go, of course, so we got to remember that. But I think we're doing pretty good. We've got a clear escape. Can we make it in one turn? I really doubt it. Yeah, that would have been too much. So, Monkey Mark... You're just going to dash super close, get you completely safe, and then we just got to basically support the extraction zone for one turn. So I think Draco takes this shot. That's a good hit. I'm happy with that. Lord Prey can definitely get out of there easily enough. Yeah, even Alpha can make it. So I say we try to kill the heavy first. Lord Prey. Someone will be able to kill it, probably. There you go. And we might even just overwatch here. Actually, I should have let Alpha take the shot and reload, strictly speaking. But yeah, we just keep a little bit of pressure. In fact, let's throw some smoke down, because why not, before we leave. And next turn we're out of here, assuming no one panics. That's what happened on our last Exalt mission that flunked. Wasn't a flunk, but it was just a bad last turn panic on our way out. Alright, that guy's another group, so they have to reload. It's kind of a waste of our reaction fire, in my opinion. I would have rather used it on the super soldiers coming in from the other side. But that's okay. We just gotta survive for one turn. Alright, we got full cover, we got smoke. I'm pretty sure it's dense smoke, I think. No, Dense Smoke is Sergeant. Maybe we don't have that yet. Anyway, we're good. You landed on our face. That's not very cool. And you landed on his face, too. As long as we can move and we're not trapped inside a truck.
Okay.
Alright, we're out of here. Nice and easy.
Commander, the operative has safely reached the extraction point with the recovered data.
That's
the
stuff.
Stick around and eliminate any remaining hostiles.
No, no. No sticking around.
We have a new objective.
I would not recommend sticking around for these Exalt missions. I'm sure it's possible, but I expect to do it without any losses is rather unlikely. And we don't even really want wounds, because the more wounds we get, the more recovery time. And, I mean, I'd rather just get out of here. Okay, that's everybody out. Let's go. It's not really an abort. You know what? This Overwatch, whatever. Yeah, I don't know. It doesn't matter how you do it. I just don't want to accidentally fail. Extract. Alright, I don't care if you think that was a terrible rating. That was an amazing rating. You should get bonus points for not having to kill all the Exalt missions on the undercover ops.
The aliens better get it together.
Got a couple promotions.
Mop the floor with them.
I still don't know what to pick sniper for this one. Before long, we'll be able to give our snipers a way to get up, like, higher. Like, we'll start giving them the ability to grapple and maybe eventually fly. So I'm thinking damn good ground may become better later in the game. Sharpshooter is certainly not bad. They're all average perks, in my opinion, as I've said many times. And we've got our scout all the way up to another level here. Now here's a question. For the battle scanner, does the smoke and mirrors count for those? Because plus 2 aim, plus a third battle scanner? I don't know if I really care. Defense. Mobility. You know, I may pick aggression just because it gives you even more insane mobility, which seems to be what a scout is all about, as far as I see it. Keeps you alive a little bit better. Bit more, you know, offensive power. Plus, because the idea with scouts is they run far and flank, you know, closer to a guaranteed crit is actually really nice. I mean, you don't use smoke grenades, so that's not going to help that. Scouts can't even get smoke grenades, so that's got to work with the battle scanners. But still, we'll just go with aggression. A little bit more mobility. All right. Some exalt. Data. Good. Well, that was nice and easy. Happy about that. Sure. Weapon fragments for engineer. That's fine. All right. We got a couple spare scopes now. That's great. A little bit easier. Okay. This is good. This is actually really nice. So we now should have... I believe it's plus 10% dodge. It may be plus 15. It's 10 or 15. So our poor aircraft, which have now all recovered, although we, of course, let them shoot down our satellite because they just swarmed us too quickly. We should have a slightly better chance of not taking damage. All right, let's see what's next. Chrysalids. They're going to make me work for it. Anyway, this guy's coming for another satellite. Well, let's check out that UFO countermeasure, see if we can get away with it. So, we do have two interceptors. It's pretty likely we'll be able to shoot it down. It's just a question of how much damage we take.
Nearing strike range.
That's a bad start. Really bad start. Oh, man. That was really, really unlikely. Or unlucky. Probably very likely. So,
contact detected.
That's almost out for a month just because you couldn't seem to hit or dodge. I'm so glad I have UFO countermeasures. Can't you see how great at dodging we are now? Like, we're way more defensive dodger. Oh, yeah, look at this! Dodging like crazy. It's pretty dodgy. Alright, well, I guess we could probably do this mission. I will, again, pick out my squad off camera and then I'll meet you guys back for that. Alright, folks, so I've selected our squad. We're bringing, I think, all specialists this time. There's no more rookies that I want to bring at the moment, seeing as they're either dead or unnamed. So I'm hoping that our downed fighter isn't terribly difficult again, and we can maybe get some nice promotion spread. You're going to notice there's a lot of of scopes today. We got more scopes this time because I constructed them. And because a lot of specialists have relatively low aim, we got lots of scopes. Other than the scout, who I gave more damage to. I don't know if that was a good idea, actually. I changed my mind. Can we give, yeah. Let's just give the Hank Flanagan some scopes. We gotta make the hits, primarily. And the specialists just don't have crazy aim yet. So, we got medkit, we got a couple arc throwers that we might try to use if we get lucky. We got an engineer who, unfortunately, until they hit Lance Corporal, they're just not very... It takes engineers a while to get good. Grenades, at least, you get twice as many grenades and you can throw them a bit further, but you don't do extra damage or destroy cover very well until they get sapper. And apparently there's a bombard eventually that you throw them across the map, which sounds amazing. Anyway, I'm going to put a cut here again, sorry, just in case the mission is super easy and I just skip it again, which is possible. So I'll see you in some amount of time. Welcome to Russia. Okay, so we've got our squad of specialists. Looks like we're not really in a corner or anything. I guess, strictly speaking, there's a corner here, but there could easily be aliens there. We've seen that before. I expect the UFO is more in that direction, and if I was really cautious, I would probably stick to the edges of the map, but I think it's a small, I don't expect too much trouble. So let's just move up to full cover, see if we see anything. It's very relatively safe. Smitchkin's not going to be the one running up. Flanagan as the scout makes a bit more sense to have a look at that tree. Looks like we've got a nice, relatively safe starting drop-off. Medic is in full cover. We'll have Broer just look a little bit further there. And the rest of people doesn't matter too much. We just don't want to activate any aliens now. So I'd say this was a safe drop-off. Sometimes you get lucky. Or just not unlucky, I guess. As long as I'm not unlucky, I'm happy. That's the key. The bad luck, I don't care if I have great luck, as long as I don't have horrible luck. It's fine there, boss. You don't really need cover like this, unless you're setting up a sniper or an infantry because you want to shoot twice rather than move. But when you haven't seen the aliens, you can leave people out in the open relatively safely. It's just the people who can't shoot and move that you should prioritize. So we know where the meld is. I really would like to get to there today. So, someone's gonna have a look from the hill up here. It's half cover, but it's got heights.
Alien object in sight.
So that's fine. Majorly Bear. Okay. Hope you guys don't mind slightly editing your names after your zombies, or whatever you want to call yourselves.
Heading to that location.
They are AI. They're something else, at least. They're definitely dead. I don't really want to go to the right. Well, that far right. We'll have a look. Come on, Broer. Alright, you're safe. Good, good. I'd like to make it to there, but it doesn't look like anyone's going to have the mobility for it, basically. Alright, so we've got Paul Hoffman, our medic. We've got who's the boss, who is not going to trigger anything. We're not going to dash. We're just going to stand in the open, but not trigger anything. The sniper will move to the tree, at least. And our explosive expert. Let me just sort of hang out in the middle there. Alright. We gotta find some aliens. We gotta find ourselves some aliens here. Is that the UFO over the left there? Well, we've heard them.
Listen.
I don't know what we heard, but the more of these missions we can do without running into, like, mechtoids, the better.
Yes, ma'am.
Less mechtoids, happy Ankylo. I mean, I was kind of concerned there that, like, after we saw mechtoids, every single mission was going to have more. But it doesn't seem to be going that way right now. I think it's more likely that we just got hit by a couple kind of ambushes rather than that's just what it's always going to be like from now on. Correct me if I'm wrong, but that's my opinion. I'm really looking forward to the armor. I think we've got like a week to go before we get it, but I have, you know, high expectations for the armor upgrade. I suppose we could put you there. It depends on the angling, but you're probably safe. We're not spread out very well. There's pros and cons. Spreading out means you can flank enemies easier. On the other hand, you're more likely to trigger a lot of extra waves, so it's not so simple. A lot of the decisions in this game, there's rarely an objectively best decision. It's like, well, that's the wrong decision, and then these other decisions are of trade-offs. Some are good, some have better this, better than that, worse than that. You know what I mean, right? It's kind of the nature of a good strategy game. If there was just an optimal move for every turn, it wouldn't be as fun. I say that now, but then when we get surrounded by ethereals, I may wish that we had an optimal move that would keep everyone alive. Alright, well, it looks like we can actually get a little bit of forward momentum here. We're not running into a lot of aliens. We don't want to trigger anything, but we should be able to dash everyone up together. I do think, from my experience in Long War, that generally keeping people grouped up together is better than splitting everyone up. As much as the splitting up makes flanking better, and I know I've had some comments saying, oh, you got to be more aggressive, move around, flank, blah, blah, blah. I think those strategies work better on vanilla. Because there's like two or three times the number of aliens on some missions, it's just better to not spawn too many at once. I'm actually really happy, Thin Men and Sectoids. I was starting to think we were never going to see these guys again already. But getting a couple easy missions like this is really, really nice. Alright, unfortunately we're going to have to shift our position a little bit. We're not in the greatest of all cover. We'll let the sniper open things up here, Shminchkin. Maybe get a kill. There you go, good job, Shminchkin. And then we got to start thinking about our flank here. So, it's not great cover, but we need Overwatch. And now we want to reposition back this direction.
There now.
Okay, some Roger. Overwatch.
I've got my eyes on.
Not a lot of good cover the direction I want to go here. I think we got three over there. I think what we're going to be doing Roger is putting that. Some people up on the log here. Maybe even having them hunker down. No, because they'll just acidify us if we hunker. Against other aliens, hunkering down works well. Against Thin Men, they're just gonna mess you up anyway. Alright, we're gonna move our assault this way. You can repair a ship. Oh, we finished that. Right, sorry. I'm like, why can't we repair ships? Yeah, arc throwers can now repair ships. When I selected that, I thought that was going to make us have a higher chance of capturing. I kind of misread it. But we are going to use shivs, so the ability to use an arc thrower to actually repair might be useful in the future, depending on how things go. Alright, Mark, that was a bad shot. 10 HP Thin Men. I mean, okay, it's nice to be fighting Thin Men, but jeesh, they're not easy. Alright. So you got flanked, of course, because that's what Thin Men do. They just know how to flank you. I suppose maybe taking the shot with the sniper was a bad idea last turn, but I really wish you'd killed him. Would have made sure no one was going to die a little bit better. Come on, don't kill anybody. You're not allowed? Or you get acid, okay. That, how did you hit three people with that acid? That's not cool. Alright, kill this thing at least. Come on, guys. These are supposed to be easy. Here we have a sniper that's almost dead that I can't... If he has 1 HP, there's nothing I can do. He's basically dead. Yeah. So... Dang it! Okay, Major Lee Bear. I know you've been acidified, but come on. 40... Mark can move up, probably throw a grenade. You'll get a little bit closer to throw a grenade somewhere. Just don't go through the acid. Yeah, that's fine.
When you love us.
Alright, Mark, I need a really good grenade out of you. Now, you could possibly kill two, but I think... I mean, this guy is flanking our sniper. We're not in a very good position here. Okay, Flanagan, I think, takes this shot. How can you not be able to kill a sectoid in one hit? I mean, it broke the suppression at least, but that was kind of disappointing. Okay, we do have a rocket. I mean, I don't like wasting rockets. I'd rather get the weapon fragments and corpses, but... Can we get, like, a hero shot here? I think 25%... I mean, it's probably gonna move, but if it could hit all three, that would be the miracle rocket. Come on, Broar. Miracle rocket. This is your chance. Well, you killed two and you destroyed his cover. I will say that's a success. So, now we just need to kill him. He's the only one left. We can save our sniper now. I'm pretty sure we can save our sniper. Alright. Everyone take a deep breath. We're doing okay. I can actually heal the sniper from here. Paul, you go run over there and heal our sniper up. I cannot. I guess... I'm not 100% sure why. I guess we don't have line of sight or something. Whatever. Anyway, we're just going to be hunkering down. Sharkout is actually... No, he's acid. Everyone's acid. Acid Bobacid. And... I guess you could have overwatched. Anyway, I'm just happy that we managed to save our sniper out of that. Because that... I was pretty sure we were going to lose somebody. So we know where the outsider is, right? I was kind of... You know, it would have been nice to go in there and start capturing stuff, but I think it was smarter to just use the rocket. Bien. And that was a good rocket. So, I'm happy things turned out the way they did, basically. So your acid will be dealt with. Bear has actually fought off his acid. No, he didn't. I couldn't see the red in the fire, but no. I was thinking he was, you know, going to heroically fight off his acid in one turn, but no. Can't get that much. Okay. And reload now that you're not acidified. You can reload. You can move to cover and then reload at least. Let's not leave the boss totally exposed. Alright. So, outsider, you're next, hey? Let's think about how we get in there. Probably from the door, really. That's probably the smart way. Okay, we still got acid on two people, so we're just going to be spending a couple turns. I'm not going to burn any more med packs just to clear out acid. I think that would be wasteful of our med packs. Just move people up a little bit closer. I don't want to risk activating them until we're ready. So just hang out there for now. The medic shouldn't see anything there, I don't expect. And... Yeah, you've still got acid. Overwatch. Alright. Hopefully these guys can burn through their acid relatively quickly, because, you know. No? Another turn of acid? Sometimes it's gone in, like, one or two turns. Sometimes it sticks around for ages. Okay, well, you can get to full cover there, Spectre. Spectre, I guess you're probably going to want me to give you, the ghost armor or something, eh? Alright, you know what? We'll start moving forward a little bit. I'm not in a rush to trigger the next group, but I don't think we need to be... Like, we've got six people able to take a shot. There's no need to really waste all day here. And you guys are still acidified. That is getting to be a pain, I would say.
Roger. I've got my eyes.
All right. What do we get? There should still be the outsider and possibly one more pod. Drones? Okay. The only question is, will there also be a cyber disk? So we finally burned off the acid with our troops, looks like. I think we just hold position and let them come to us. They did not activate. So we just get people into cover at least. Lay off a couple overwatches. and let the drones come at us. If it's just drones, we'll be laughing. If there's a cyber disc, well, you know. Hopefully you guys will be alright. Everyone Overwatch. Everybody Overwatch? Sometimes the Overwatch shortcut doesn't get everything. Alright, three shots. Yeah. It's good and dead, guys. It's good and dead. Alright, well, maybe we're not going to be capturing much this episode. Alright, well, 87% Schminchkin. Pretty good shot, I would say. That's the stuff. Now, I'm not really keeping track of who's been getting kills for promotions purposes, but I'll give the medic a shot here, because it's nice when your medics get promotions. Okay, let's just Overwatch again. If that's all we got today, this is a nice easy mission. Oh no, there's at least one more. Sure, someone maybe get it. Oh well, you can't always win on reaction. And it's backing up. Alright, well, if that's the last enemy practically, other than the outsider, of course, let's just be patient and make him come to us. If he doesn't come forward, I might move, but I think we'll activate the outsider if he actually moves forward here, so.
Will do.
Probably should have moved Shark out a bit up.
Copy that.
Do a little bit of repositioning. And then Overwatch.
I've got my eyes on.
And I want you, Flanagan, to start preparing for the door. We gotta get ready for that outsider. Mark, you can also prepare for the door. As long as he doesn't automatically trigger. Yeah, we can hear him. We know where he is.
You hear that?
Okay. So one thing I have learned, and I know I don't do this very often, but when you're preparing for a breach, you should probably steady weapon first before you activate. I could have also put people on the corners here, but I think it's more likely that they would have activated the outsider, so I didn't want to do that.
Yes, ma'am.
Broer is... Although you should be steadying, you can steady. I was thinking maybe a reload would have been better, but... Overwatch for the drone. And, I don't know, you can just hunker down, I guess. And steady. So next turn, we'll leave a couple people on Overwatch for the drone. And someone gets a shot here. So this was a good decision. Yeah! I almost decided to give that guy a steady weapon, but that worked out really well. So if you really wanted to be cautious, you'd set everybody up with more steady weapons. I think we're fine. Let's just do it. Come on out, outsider. Or come on in, outsider. At least we get our Illyrium generator. That's nice. So because of our steady weapon, this guy shouldn't really have a chance. I would really like to get... Oh, you don't have a shot. I guess it's just a... Just not quite the angle for Schminchkin. I would like to let the engineer get the kill so that we can get at least Sapper. That will make him a lot more useful. Okay, 81% miss. That's kind of annoying. 50%. I don't care if this is a miss. That's pretty normal. I mean, I am going to start to care. Don't get me wrong. At some point, it's a problem. 94. Alright, 5 damage. What did I give? You've got a laser rifle. Well, you probably won't be able to kill him, but give it a shot. Yeah, 1 damage left. It's perfect capture, but... I think we just let Major Bear get a shot.
Moving.
He doesn't have a promotion yet. You know how I love infantry. 60%. Come on, infantry. Yeah. I'll show him. I'll take it. And I'll even keep that video. I think that was, although it was a pretty easy video, I don't think it dragged on too long. And there was a couple good plays, so we won't be cutting that out. I'm sorry, Schminchkin, that you got flanked and injured, but you survived and you got a couple kills. So we got 3 promotions. I can't complain. We're going to give Gunner... I mean, holo targeting is very handy, but covering fire is good. We haven't seen it trigger very often, but when it does, it can be a lifesaver. So we'll go with that. Paul, the medic, seems to be smoke, is basically what I always give medics. And Flanagan, the scout, rapid reaction. mostly for the stats. Willpower and aim, it's just too good. And rapid reaction isn't a bad skill either. Alright, so we got a power source. I keep calling them Illyrium. It's power source. I think you get more Illyrium from them too, but... So that was pretty good. That's been good. I think we'll be ready to wrap the episode up then pretty soon. Let's just find out what our next mission is, maybe, or get the armor done, but we'll be ready to stomp. Sure, give me more engineers. I don't know how long I should keep doing those. Like, is there a point at which you have enough engineers? I think we could go a lot more than this, but, you know, if I get to 100, do I stop worrying about it? I don't know, at some point. Alright, chrysalid autopsy. Yay, we finally know about chrysalids, just what everyone loves. I think the chrysalid corpses have been sitting around in cold storage for months before we finally got to that. So chitin plating, I believe, is really good if you've got enough chrysalid corpses. And I think we do a berserker autopsy again. I know the aerospace thing is good, that's the next thing I'm going to do, the next big thing. But it will require a lot of alloys and money, so we can kind of wait till next month. We need to capture a medium or something UFO, or another large would be great. Anyway, berserker 5 days, engineering, I'll show you guys our chitin plating, because I believe it's better than what we're currently using for armor, but you need a lot of carcasses. So 3 health in an accessory slot is better than 2. It also doesn't say it has any weight, so if this is a free weight item that protects you in melee, gives you 3 health, that is amazing. It almost makes me want to do a couple terror missions and kill some chrysalids without rockets. Almost. You know, you'd think after that Newfoundland mission we would have had lots, but whatever. Anyway, done is done. Yay, we've got another shiv back. Yay, that was one of the ones that got blown up. Alright, Kestrel armor, that is good. Plus a little bit of alloys back. That's actually really good too. Arc thrower is done. Oh, nice. See, this is why you want workshops. So, actually, do we have enough alloys to consider building something else? We might. Or I could save it for, like, a foundry project. I should probably get alien metallurgy next. We've got enough meld now. We just need some money. So we'll just wait till we get some money. And the earlier you get this, the more alloy. And I can tell you from experience what little I have, that we're going to need more alloy. So spend a little bit of alloy, spend a lot of meld to get more alloy in the future. And this is relatively cheap, but I'm going to get salvage first. We're still a ways off from Psy, right? Facilities. Actually, we're 5 days off from that. That'll be interesting. Ooh, who wants to be psionic? What do you think, guys? Flight computers are important. I'm pretty sure I need them for research. Not this time. What do we need them for? I'm pretty sure we need them to make firestorms. Yeah, we definitely need to save them. We're going to want to use these for the Nexus, the Nexi. Yeah. So yeah, we're not going to give them that. Sorry, guys. Wherever you're from, you're not getting any. And meld, yeah, I think I decided meld was too valuable to give up. Sorry, folks, you just can't ask for everything. Sometimes you just gotta make do with what you got.
Commander.
All right. Well, I was really hoping we would have had the armor before the next mission.
Abductions in progress at each marked site on the hologlobe.
Did we get the armor? Oh, maybe we didn't. Yeah, we did. Never mind. Forget that. We got armor. So just for interest's sake, if we were to equip it, carapace armor, it's the same weight as TAC armor, but way more HP. Plus you get some nice shiny metal on your suit. And if you want to wear Kestrel, it's the same weight as the TAC vest, except it actually, well, the Kestrel isn't very good, let's be honest. Plus 1 HP over the vest, and plus 5 defense. So I'm not going to want to give... I think my split, 2 Kestrel to 6 Carapace, was a good idea. Anyway, We get a panic mission next episode, but we get armor, finally. So I think that bodes well. And we've had... Today was a triple mission, although I didn't show you the first one. I think we're in a good spot. So thanks for watching. I hope you guys have enjoyed. And things are looking up. We're losing a trooper here and there, but all in all, we're making advantages. We're making advances. We're getting new armor. We're getting new weapons. We'll figure it out. All right, folks. See you next time.